Hey, what's going on, Bully World? This is Zeke, Bully Badass TV. I want to do a quick little video today, just talking about something that's probably very relevant to the American bully community. I will include the link to this article in the description of this video. The article is called Purebred versus Mixed Breed. Obviously, there's been, you know, there are a ton of accusations about the origin of the American bully and how it came about. My personal thought is that, you know, the American bully is a designer breed of dog. There are tons of designer breed of dogs out there now that are gaining in popularity. The American bully has every right to exist and every right to be developed into a purebred dog. So real quick with this article, first let me break down, they give you a little side note as to what a cross, the difference between a crossbreed and a mixed breed. We all know that a purebred dog is obviously sire and the dam are of the same breed. A crossbred dog is the offspring of two purebred dogs of different breeds. So the sire and the dam are different breeds, but they themselves are purebreds of the breed that they belong to. And then a mixed breed dog is basically a mutt, meaning that the sire and or the dam have multiple breeds in their background. So let me get into this article real quick. The article starts like this. Purebred dogs, crossbred dogs, and mixed breed dogs all make excellent companions. If you're looking for a dog for a specific purpose, say hunting, sheep herding, or top level obedience competition, then you probably want to choose a breed that typically excels in that area. It may be too that a cross of specific breeds will give you the traits that you want. For instance, a Labrador Retriever, a Golden Retriever cross will likely be a good-natured dog that likes water and loves to retrieve. Now this is important because when you think about getting a dog, a lot of people think, oh, a lot of people with means and money think, oh, I'll just get me a purebred dog. The reality of it is that a purebred dog may not suit your purpose. So it's very important when you pick a dog that you understand how much money you're gonna spend and what you're gonna get. And I say that the most important thing that you should always worry about is the health of the dog, because you know, a dog with poor health will cost you a lot of money in the long run, a lot more than the purchasing price, all right? But then also it goes on to say this, don't be duped into thinking that mixed breeds will result in healthier offspring. The truth is that puppies, whether purebred or mixed, inherit the genes from each parent. If the parents pass along genes for hereditary disease, the pups stand a good chance of having that disease as well. Hybrid vigor, the idea that unrelated parents produce healthier offspring, works only if natural selection is in operation. In the wild, a dog with clinical symptoms of a debilitating disease, such as hip dysplasia or epilepsy, would not be able to survive and so would not be able to pass on its genes. But in modern world, with reasonable veterinary care and constant food source, dogs with serious, even deadly problems do survive long enough to produce lots of pups. So that whole concept of hybrid vigor, which, like it says, exists only in nature, does not count in civilization. You know, so don't let some guy sell you like, oh yeah, I got these mixed breeds, or I got these crossbreed dogs, I've crossbred them for health and stability and temperament, all these things. The reality of it is that a puppy, a dog, will only be as healthy as his parents. So the idea, and I mean, don't get me wrong, there's a lot of problems that are inherent in purebred dogs that, you know, they're still there. But the reality of it is that as someone that's looking to get a pet or looking to purchase a dog, you want to look for a dog's parents to be healthy. So you want to breed it with a track record of healthy dogs. Just one more thing I wanted to get to you guys that's in here. Just one more thing about the purebred dogs that this article, this is actually the last paragraph. I'll read that to you and that'll be summing it up. So you may have heard that purebred dogs are inbred and therefore plagued with inherited health problems as well as flaky, high-strung dispositions. To some extent, this is true of poorly bred purebreds. The reality is that all living things are prone to inherited problems and dogs are no exception. Purebred dogs do inherit problems, but so do mixed breeds. There are advantages to a responsibly bred, let me repeat that because it's really important, responsibly Bred, Purebred. First, you can look for a breeder who tries to breed away from problems known in the breed. Failing that, you can make an informed decision. If you know that a breed is prone to early death from cancer, you can decide whether it's a risk you can live with and whether the short life expectancy it outweighs by the pleasure of that dog of that breed will give you, or that breed will give you. Whew, it was some tough reading going on right there, people. Anyway, the difference between crossbred, mixed bred, and purebred dogs pretty much summed up right there. Again, if you're looking to buy a dog, if you're looking to purchase a dog, think about your needs, think about your lifestyle, and also, most importantly, think about the health of the dog. Understanding that, you know, when you take responsibility for an animal, when you purchase an animal, you are the custodian of that animal. If that dog gets cancer, that dog has epilepsy, it is your responsibility. We can no longer think that it's just cool or it's appropriate to, you know, put dogs down or, you know, discard them, you know, drive them, you know, 50 miles from home and kick them out the car. That's no longer appropriate. It's actually disgusting. It's vile. It's inhumane. So let's all be human. Let's all love one another. Let's all watch Bully Badass TV, purebred, mixed bred, crossbred. Figure out what's best for you. Understanding that, and also understand this, that mixed bred is probably going to, in most cases, going to be available to you free of charge or at very low cost at your local animal shelter. That's what's up. My name is Zeke. This is Bully Badass TV. Peace.